Hey everyone, Jordan Curran here from Meaningful Marketing, and in today's screen share and blog post, I'm going to go over how to add keywords to your Google AdWords ads and campaigns. I won't get into how to set up campaigns or ad groups and ads. I've already done that, so you can click on the link below this video or in my blog, and I'll show you how to do that. But for sake of today, we're just going to go into keywords. So I'm going to show you how to find out which keywords are being searched for your product or service, how often they're being searched, as well as how to avoid wasting money on searches that people aren't going to buy your product or service. So we're going to hopefully save you some money and make sure that you have your keyword match option set up to be exactly as the product or service you offer. I've seen a couple clients who have been wasting quite a bit of money on clicks that don't deal with their product or service, and it's for somebody searching for something totally different. They're not a buyer, so I'm going to show you how to avoid wasting money on clicks by going into the keyword matching area. So to begin, we're going to go into our dashboard under AdWords. We're going to click on our tools, and we're going to go into Keyword Planner. It used to be named Keyword Tool, I think it was. Yeah, you could find out how many searches are. It's the same idea, just renamed. Quite handy for not only AdWords, but also organic SEO and for content marketing as well. That's another blog post down the road. So we're going to click on Search for New Keyword and Ad Group Ideas. So what we're going to do is we're going to go Your Product or Service. So I'll go through our example. We're going to do Search Engine Optimization. Should spell that right. Landing page. So what I'm just going to do is, let's just say for the sake of it, the website ranks well organically for some search terms. We got the landing page keyword optimized for quite a few organic terms, but we want to just show up in the ads as well. So we want to have the ads covered for people who are going to click there, but also we want to have the organic listings covered. So we're just going to target a lot of the keywords that we're already targeting organically where we're ranking well. So this landing page is optimized for the keywords we're going to select. And that's one thing you got to be aware of. You have to have a landing page that has your keywords on it, that's used on there, and that's useful and relevant. That's going to convert people. That's how Google will gauge the quality of your ads and the keywords you're going after, and it'll determine, you know, how your click-through rate will be, what the landing page experience is, and so on. So make sure you have the keywords that you get from this whole research and put them on the landing page. So your landing page could just have some text. It could be your home page. It could be a separate page if you want to track things. Just make sure at the end of it, once you get all these keywords, those keywords are being used on that landing page. And then lastly, product category. We're going to go into internet marketing for us. So we're going to have a bunch of subcategories here too. We're going to go into, say, search engine marketing. We're going to go into search engine optimization. So now to find out how often some of these search terms that we might get are searched, we're going to look for our area. So target area, you can select a city. We're going to go hyper local. So for us, we've selected a few areas, Sydney, Colwood, Victoria. And what's different here is that we're not able to actually search the whole area like we are able to target with our campaign. And if my last video on campaigns, you could target a radius. So we actually target a 20-kilometer radius around Colwood, British Columbia here, and we were able to cover the whole area. This just seems to be giving us just a small area. I don't know how accurate this is going to be, but you can get the idea. Let's say if you're in San Francisco, which is one of my favorite cities, by the way. I'm just going to throw that out there. We could throw in San Francisco. So it's going to cover quite a bit of San Francisco if we do that. So once you figure out where you're targeting, you just want to hit that in, add it in there, and it'll be under here in our locations, and then you're just going to hit done. So this will give you an idea of what's going on, how many people are searching your terms within that targeting area. Languages, you know, you can choose your languages. Search network, Google, or Google search partners. We're just going to go Google. Negative keywords. So we're going to try to avoid people searching cheap, say, search engine optimization or cheap SEO packages because we don't want to have people clicking on our ads who are strictly looking for cheap packages. You know, if anybody's searching this package, they're probably looking for the $99 a month type package, which we do not offer. We're more of a premium. So we're just going to avoid that kind of that keyword by putting it in here. We could put a bunch of others like let's go SEO blogs or techniques, just so we want to make sure that we're getting people who are actually searching for our service and not searching for tips. And then your date range, we're going to have this to a year just to give us a good idea of what's going on. Keyword options, I'm not going to get into this too much. Include, exclude, you know, we can get into more of the that stuff a little bit later on. But for just the sake of purposes and speeding this screencast along, we'll leave everything as is. And then we're going to hit get ideas. So we're going to get a little printout of what's going on here. Now you can get some ad group ideas. I personally don't like this because, for example, I just typed in, you know, my landing page deals with Victoria, BC, yet it's given us some Toronto search engine optimization terms. So instead I'm going to go to keyword ideas, and we're just going to get individual ideas here. And what I like to do is I like to sort everything by the highest average monthly searches. So you're going to see your search terms. Now search engine optimization, we're going to add that in because that's obviously a targeted term. SEO, SEO Victoria, Victoria SEO. Now, one thing I want to talk about is search engine optimization toolkit. You have to think about the intent of a lot of these keywords. If somebody is searching for the search engine optimization toolkit, they're looking for something useful. So in this case, I would create a separate ad for this keyword that directs people to my local SEO training kit, which is, you know, I think it's about 30 or 40 page ebook. PDF. So I would actually create an ad specifically for like toolkit techniques and things like that to get people to land on that training kit page. So again, just think about the intent of people and what they might be searching and what they're looking for. So I'm not going to add this in because I want to use this to sell our monthly packages. And somebody searching for toolkit, you know, they're looking for an actual piece of information. They're not looking for pricing. So we're going to leave that alone. And like I say, you could target them. Just make sure you target them with the proper pieces of information they want. SEO services company, that's what we want. SEO free, obviously, we don't want that. So just kind of speed things along. We'll show you what's going on. We've only got about four or five keywords in here. So we got our five keywords in here, and now we're just going to save them to account. We're going to hit save to account. I don't want to create a new campaign. I've already showed you how to do that. We're going to add to an existing campaign. So we can create a new ad group, or you can add to an existing ad group within a campaign. So I'm going to select that. Then I'm going to hit my Victoria SEO text ad campaign, and then I'm going to add it to my SEO Victoria ad group. Hit save and continue, and bam, they're just copied over there. Then we're going to click on our view new keywords, and we're going to see our keywords. All loaded into that SEO Victoria ad group. So I'll talk about the landing page stuff, quality score, cost per click stuff a little bit later on in another video. But I want to wind this down as it's taking a little bit longer than I expected. And just show you the last thing, and that's how to avoid wasting clicks on people searching for terms that aren't necessarily buyers or relevant to your service or product that you want to offer. So what you want to do is you want to make sure that you have your match type for these search terms set to exact. This will really make sure that you are saving money and getting people who are really searching for your keywords to click through to your website. So I'm going to select on my keywords. I'm going to change my keyword match types. So right now these are set up as broad match, and broad match is just strictly I'm targeting one of my keywords here, search engine optimization. So if somebody was searching for search engine optimization toolkit, techniques, blog, whatever it is, my ad's going to show up because it's broad match. Broad match just simply means that if your search term is anywhere in that search term of the searcher, your ad will show up. Doesn't matter about the other stuff on side. So someone could be searching for SEO, let's say SEO, yeah, techniques or tools or blogs. Again, I don't want people searching for that to land on my thing. So I'm going to change my match type to exact match from broad, just to make sure that we're getting people who are exactly searching those terms and having our ads display for them just to match the intent of what they're looking for. Again, if I was looking for to drive people to my blog or my training kit, I'd go after those toolkit type terms. But for right now, we want to make sure that we're being effective with our spend and Google, and we're not just getting a bunch of clicks. We want to get relevant clicks. So I'm going to hit save, make those changes. What we're going to see is now brackets around these keywords, and that's the exact match keyword. I'll post a link below to like the terminology of what the definition of broad, phrase, and exact match is. But for right now, it's just strictly all about exact match. As an example, you know, I had a client went into their AdWords campaign and their keywords and noticed that they were getting a lot of people searching for jobs and not their actual service. So they were actually paying per click for people to land on their website looking for jobs. And he said to me, you know, we're basically recruiting people with our AdWords. I said, yeah, unfortunately, you've spent quite a bit of money on people searching ads, searching for jobs and then clicking on your ads. So the way to get rid of that is to make sure that your keywords are exactly matched to that keyword, because you can waste a lot of money. So just be wary about that. And again, that's how you're going to save money in the long run and make sure that you're getting qualified leads clicking on your ads and not just a bunch of wasted thing. I know a lot of people, they just want to get in here and they want to see a mass amount of people clicking on their ads. But if you're not targeting the right people, you're just going to waste a lot of money. And I did this last year. I set up a campaign for Nanaimo SEO, actually in a local SEO. I had a blog post, it was local SEO dead, and just kind of went off about, you know, local SEO is not dead. And what I had was actually a lot of keywords that were not matching the types of search terms that I was targeting. So if you want to find out if you've used broad match in the past, if you want to find out what search terms your ad showed for and what people clicked on, you can go under details once you're in the keywords tab of your ad group and hit selected and then go to all. So we can see that a bunch of weird keywords show up. So for some reason, this ad was showing up when people typed in Channel 7 News Online, and for some reason, somebody clicked on this. So obviously, you can see my clicks and impressions is not very good. A 0.22% click-through rate is terrible. Luckily, that only cost me 70 cents. Now, local search, who knows what somebody could be typing in there. And again, because it's broad match, it showed up. I'm not sure what the intent of somebody is. However, again, it's one click at 117, a little bit better click-through rate for a $3.81 cost. Now, sometimes you got to wonder, why would people click on a Channel 10 news website if they see that ad as local? This has nothing to do with Channel 10 news website. Who knows? They just click on it anyways. So you got to watch out for that. But kind of going down here, let's see what else. If I want to remove some of these terms, I could go back to what I just showed you and I could change the match type from broad to exact, but I could basically just say let's remove some of these terms. So I'm going to highlight some of these terms where we showed up for Sri Lanka News Online, GMO News Online, let's say what else, and well, we already got that Fox. So we've got those two terms, we've got them highlighted. We're just going to hit add as negative keyword. And we're going to add them to the campaign level. So that basically what would happen here is those will be excluded from showing up when people actually type in that Sri Lanka News Online search term. So there's two ways to get rid of these broad match keywords where your ads might be showing up for people not particularly searching for what you offer. And that's to do it this way, or that's to go back, like I said, under the keyword tab, highlighting them all and then changing your keyword match types from broad to exact. So that's my screencast on and blog post on keywords, adding keywords, you know, making sure you're targeting the right keywords. I'm going to go over in my next video landing page optimization, you know, to get a better quality score, and as well as just going through the cost per click on these keywords you're targeting, and then analyzing these data, like where your ads are showing up and things like that. So stay tuned for that video. I want to thank you for tuning into this one. It's probably about 15, 20 minutes now. No matter, there's some useful information in here. And if you've enjoyed it, please be sure to head back to my website to sign up for the newsletter, as well as share this on Facebook or Twitter to any business people you know. I think this is a valuable piece of content here, and it'll help a lot of your friends and business owners save money if they are advertising with Google, just strictly alone on this exact match keyword search tool. So thanks for your attention, and I will see you in my next video.